After what I'd seen that whole night with him, heck, it's hard to say anybody had an advantage at that point. I mean, I hit this guy with everything but the kitchen sink, and I was looking for that to hit him with.
They touch gloves, and here we go again.
In the 10th round, I was tired. I mean, it was a tough fight, so yes, I was tired.
Oh, what a left hook by Castillo, and Corrales is down.
Right on the chin. Right on the chin. I believe it was left hook, but I really didn't remember that well. It's pretty quick.
3, 4.
I don't think anything. It's a fight. You don't have a lot of time to think. Well, first off, look at my wife. You know, wink at her, let her know I'm okay.
6, 7.
Catch up with the count. Get up.
Given the commands to come to me, everything was fine, and he was ready to go.
What a dramatic moment here in round 10.
I'm still buzzing, though. I'm still buzzing from the first knockdown.
Castillo looking to finish it here. He goes down again. Takes the mouthpiece out.
I didn't think he was going to get up. I figure he doesn't get up. No matter where I hit him on the head, he will go down again, and the fight will be over.
I remember pulling the mouthpiece out of my mouth. And it's hard to hold onto a mouthpiece in gloves. You got no fingers. You don't, they can slip right out your hand very easily.
And that the mouthpiece is out of his mouth, I said, oh, okay, yeah, we're going to have to deduct the point.
I'm going to penalize, take 1 point off.
What? Look at the replay. That's the first thing I said, for what? Man, I didn't drop it on purpose. It's a slip out of my hand.
I don't know if he did it on purpose, but if he did, the results were good for him. He received about 39 seconds between the knockdown, getting his mouthpiece cleaned, and the deduction of the point.
Get it flat on him now. Time in, let's go. Dreadful round for Corrales. Again, Castillo going back to work.
I knew Corrales was hurt. I was overconfident. It was my error. I may have been too confident, and he hit me.
If Corrales can get through this round, he may very well need a knockout.
Castillo runs in real hard, comes in real hard, walks into a straight right hand.
Corrales coming back after being on the canvas twice.
None of them tried to hurt him. He has no more steam left.
Corrales swinging.
Now I'm unloading everything. I can tell him he's hurt.
Castillo's in trouble.
And then a hard, hard right hand. And with another hook, there's Tony Meek sliding in.
And the fight is over. Corrales with a remarkable, dramatic turnaround.
He was hit with a barrage of punches. His hands went down. His head was limp, and that was it. Once a fighter is unable to protect himself, the fight's over.
I was in bad shape, so it was a good stoppage. But if he had not been given 40 seconds when he went down, it may have been a different story.
I was too tired to be happy. I couldn't believe this guy had fought me like that. We kind of stuck together for the rest of our lives. We're tied together by one heck of a fight. And the one thing about fights like that, there has to be a repeat to it.
When he couldn't make weight. So despite the controversy, will they continue where they left off 5 months ago? In essence, is this round 11? The prevailing opinion, no matter what, another shootout is inevitable. We'll soon see. Because of the controversy, Steve, it just adds so many new layers to this fight that didn't exist before.
But all that stuff's over now. It's a fight. And it's already a good fight because they're going at it right on the inside.
Castillo, normally not a fast starter. He gets stronger as the fight goes on. That one of the reasons the game plan of the first fight was for Corrales to jump right on.
Hold it.
Oh, new as far as Castillo is concerned. Big left hook again by Castillo. So Castillo starting strong, and there's a right hand over the top by Jose Luis Castillo. Corrales missing. Steve, we were wondering if... big right hand by Corrales. We were wondering if Corrales could make any adjustments. No adjustments. He's happy again to fight Castillo's fight. Really bends and gets full power on that shot almost every time. Castillo trying to force a third fight, a trilogy with a victory here tonight. And then he can fight for the belts. Look at these series of left hooks by Castillo, landing repeatedly on the head of Corrales. And then a right uppercut on the inside by Castillo. Another one, a combination, and it's all Castillo. Back comes Corrales with a left hook. But a right hand by Castillo, and then it's Corrales' turn. Here we go again. Now Corrales sends Castillo back. And a right uppercut by Castillo. And they continue to trade. And this crowd is into it.
Bring him. Maybe 5 months in terms of the recovery from the beating he took to his face. Maybe 5 months wasn't enough.
Yeah, factor going in was who recovered quicker. Corrales. The momentum shifting for Corrales here, but then just when you say that, of course, Castillo comes back. Oh, there's a big left hook by Castillo right on the chin. And once again, they meet in the proverbial phone booth in the center of the ring. Oh, Castillo. That's something we could have said in the first part as well. Uppercuts on the inside, a very valuable weapon for Castillo. The chance of Castillo from the crowd. Only 5,000 for the first fight. Maybe closer to 16, 17,000 here, 18. Who knows? Hard to say.
Steve, when they're on the inside like this,
was momentarily dazed.
Hold the hand.
Can he hang on? And he continues to just stand in there. He doesn't hold or he doesn't box. He fights.
And he's walking into the shots. He's walking into the fire.
Incredible.
He's still inching forward,
and
even when
throwing.
Hurt.
And landing. And frustrating Castillo. Oh, what a left hook after the two body punches. And a right hand by Castillo. Corrales remains on his feet and remains throwing punches.
Let's go.
Unbelievable chin and heart by Corrales.
All right, careful. Come on.
In round three, Corrales willing to trade the right hand of all punches, which it was the left hook the whole fight for Castillo. And after landing that big right, he hurts Corrales again with a left uppercut. And at the end of the round, Corrales was pushing Castillo back. What kept Chico up?
It's meant to be.
Right.
Round four, scheduled for 12. Rugged round, Corrales, who was nearly put down, but he's coming back strong. The swelling continues under the right eye. His nose is swollen.
His nose is swollen big, and you know what? Corrales right now trying to commit to a strong jab. It's the first time we've seen it.
And Corrales continues. Oh! And down goes Corrales here in the fourth.
5, 6, 7, 8, 9.
Oh, Joe Cortez stops it. He got up at 10, and Cortez has stopped the fight, and Corrales has evened the score. Castillo has evened the score. Jose Luis Castillo with a fourth round knockout. Castillo, historically a slow starter, gets it done fast.
And we were worried about Castillo draining himself trying to make weight.